So I have put four stories tonight and I really want the country to consider these 4 points. One is Lalu Prasad, absurdity. I mean, 20 years back, it's like a Hindi movie called 20 Saal Baad. Literally, 20 years after the case, he's being charged cheated. He seems very happy with it. Look at the case in Kolkata. The police are so scared. Look at the case which Kripa Shankar Singh goes missing. The chief minister smiles. I don't know where he is. Now let's come down to basics here. My question to you, Mr. M.N. Singh, is the bottom line is the lack of honest police officers and bureaucrats who can take on the politicians. That's the problem.
Well, Arnab,
they cannot take on the political class.
Arnab, I think advocate Ms. Kamini Jaiswal put it very correctly. It is the complete control of the political class over the bureaucracy and the police which has made the police a helpless machinery. Unless you introduce the desired police reform, which has been hanging fire for years, I think you should have no hopes.
No.
Thanks to the media, which has been so vocal and so critical, that there is some check at least.
No.
But coming to this.
So one minute. In this case of West Bengal, Sankarshan does not agree. Let me tell you, in the case of West Bengal.
About Lalu Yadav's being charged sheeted 20 years later,
it is shameful.
It is, of course, manipulation of the machinery, CBI. But of course, the fault lies with the legal system, the criminal justice system in this country. The case is pending in the court. If the court is framing the charge 20 years later, who is to blame?
I disagree with you. I think Sankarshan also does. But let me tell you why I disagree. I disagree with you because the case of, you know, this SPS Rathore, I think that tormentor policeman, right? Ruchika Girota's tormentor. When he manipulated the system.
Because you pursued the case in between, you forgot Lalu Yadav.
Please don't blame the media for everything. The question is that he was using his pull. And he was using his pull over policemen and bureaucrats as much as he was using his pull over politicians. Policemen and bureaucrats are part of the system.
You are right. I agree with you.
Sankarshan,
coming to Mamata Banerjee's case, maybe I was wrong.
I just want to...
Sankarshan is rebutting. Come on, Sankarshan.
I just want to add a strong... right. Of course, the politicians are deeply guilty of manipulating the entire system. But I do not think that should also, you know, mean at the same time that bureaucrats and policemen are totally free of any guilt. I have time and again, election after election, I have seen droves of bureaucrats and policemen, you know, like coxswains, you know, swaying by the wind, looking at which party is going to win, lining up at their houses. You will see
they're part of the system.
You go to Lucknow today and you will see bureaucrats and policemen lining up at the doors of the party they expect to win. Nobody is forcing them. You know, this is a class that has a vested interest in the so-called establishment. It has deep vested interest.
Yes.
It is hand in glove. Of course, the politicians manipulate them, but I think they have put themselves in a position where they can be manipulated.
No, one second. Kamini Jaiswal wants to come in.
That's very true, but the question is how to break through, how to improve the situation. It's very easy to blame the police or the bureaucracy. The question is that is a fact we all accept. How to break away from this is a mute question.
It's not a question of blaming anybody. Yes, Kamini Jaiswal.
It's just a system.
Just
it's not a question
system.
Of blaming anybody. They are ready to be subservient. And then, can you forget that sight of the policeman cleaning the shoe of the chief minister? If the policeman is ready to stoop to that level, what can a politician do also? I mean, at the most, they'll transfer you. The policemen also, they also, because they are not clean, because they are dishonest, because they are corrupt, they need the protection of the politician, so they are ready to dance to that tune.
Absolutely, and that's why once again the question goes out tonight. One second. Today, who is responsible for the recent Mumbai Congress chief till recently going missing? Tell me, TSR Subramaniam, who is responsible? He's gone missing. I think it's the most ridiculous event in the history of recent independent India that a Mumbai police Congress chief goes missing. The police say, sorry, we don't know. The man has just disappeared. You know, like a group of flamingos who came to Mumbai and flew off.
Well, I do not
know
if the police have really
disappeared.
Said so.
They know
everything.
I don't know
where you got this message, this information.
They don't know. They say we don't know his whereabouts. They say we don't know his whereabouts.
I don't want to defend Kripa Shankar Singh. Kripa Shankar Singh has to face the music.
No, he's not facing the music right now. Why did it take the Mumbai High Court to instruct the police to file an FIR against the former Congress chief?
Well, simple, because there was no complaint with the police at that stage.
So there was no complaint. So the authorities are completely clueless about his disproportionate assets.
No. Haven't, well, that is the matter of inquiry. With, no, you know what happened in the High Court and how the High Court has put this.
Come on, this man. Yes, T.S.R. Subramaniam, please.
They know everything. They don't want to use it.
They don't want to use it.
I think the short answer to your question. It has been raised today by you in the TV. He will be arrested tonight or tomorrow morning. If you had not raised it today on the TV, it would not happen for the next month or so. I mean, that's the short answer to your question.
Why should it be like that?
There's a larger issue which Shankar Sen mentioned, you mentioned, and also Kamini Jayaswal. The larger issue is, yes, bureaucrats and policemen are... my friend got a Supreme Court order on police reforms. This was 8 years back. And it covered this for scientific management of the police force. 8 years back, Supreme Court ordered. No state government has complied with these orders. Government of India has not complied with these orders. I have got now a PIL with 86 secretaries to government, governors, DGs, police, all of us, we have got a case saying we want scientific management. This is public management. This is not a private kitchen management in a private house. The force is not a private force, it's a public force. And I bet that even if we get the court orders, government is not going to comply. Because this is a fundamental thing. So if the instrument is not being used well, it's a good instrument, mind you. The best people in India are the instrument. If it is not being used, yes, it's partly the instrument's fault, but largely the person who wields the instrument's fault. If a good horse is available, not ridden well, the rider is terrible.
That's true. It's a dereliction of duty. And I'm sorry, Mr. Evans, you can't pass it off by saying the political class, you know, is responsible. You can't pass it. The political class, the police, the bureaucracy are all part of the system here. Everyone's colluded. If Kripa Shankar Singh is missing, everyone's colluded to have him missing. I am simply asking tonight, and Neelam Kathara, I want you to answer this. You tell me, as someone, you've lost your own son and you're fighting the case, right? A 66-year-old man is killed because he wanted water. In Delhi today, he's pushed, he's killed because he wanted water. I mean, what is the message we are sending to everyone today?
Well, in this case, the policeman should have been put under arrest immediately.
He's not been.
Because the man has died.
He's not been.
It's a criminal misconduct, and therefore, straight away.
Wait, one second.
I do not know what is delaying it.
Miss Kathara.
I'm sorry, it's not even appearing to be human. The police commissioner has not apologized to the family, forget taking any action.
He should do that.
So even, you know, that is the value the common man has for the past that be. The first law I think we need is that politicians or persons who are being who have a charge sheet against them should not be allowed to contest elections. Otherwise, they will not care. On the positive side, yes, we've had an incident where junior police officers in Uttar Pradesh have spoken out their mind. About 18 of them offered to resign because things were not being done according to the law. So let's hope there is some thing to be happy about from the younger lot of the IPS officers.
I hope so. But one point, you know, if this had been a death of a VVIP or a VVIP's relative in a same manner, would the policeman have been able to go away scot-free? If a VVIP on the road would ask for water and he was pushed and killed, what would have happened, Sankarshan, in Delhi today?
Arnab, if I may make a point, I think what Mr. Subramaniam was saying is on the dot. It's not about one individual or a set of individuals setting an example. It's about setting in place a system by which... In which such kind of misuse, abuse, manipulation cannot take place. He rightly said about, you know, reams and reams of, Reform Commission reports are just gathering dust. Nobody bothers about them. I think there has to be some sort of pressure mounted. I don't know what will
Sankarshan.
Bring it on.
Sankarshan, let me share one fact.
Not, individuals will not change the system.
Let me share one fact. And I want
they
everyone
can
to...
Out. They can
shine out. The Supreme Court. Isn't this contempt of the Supreme Court, that the Supreme Court directions for police reforms are not being actioned by the state police? And if it is a contempt of the Supreme Court, why doesn't the Supreme Court react?
Yes, it is. But who cares? Because the law and the lawmakers and the system works for the VVIPs.
Who cares?
It works for the VVIPs, so who cares? Now, let me tell you one fact here. Kamini Jayaswal, I want to share this with you and MN Singh. In the case of Kripa Shankar Singh, this case was being investigated by the state's anti-corruption bureau. And the state's anti-corruption bureau gave Kripa Shankar Singh a clean chit. This finding of the anti-corruption bureau was rejected by the High Court. And now we have the findings of the Enforcement Directorate. So point is, this man was first, he was given a clean chit by policemen, sir. Sorry, by policemen, right? Then he was caught again. And now that he's been caught, the police is in a state of shock.
There was no complaint, is all known.
Yeah, yeah, right? Kamini Jaiswal, isn't this expose it?
He's got his petition. He's already filed a petition in the Supreme Court. It's already coming up tomorrow.
Yeah, so he's buying time.
Justice for him.
So he's buying time. He's buying time.
He's there in the Supreme Court tomorrow. He's not buying time. He's managing to get away, and he's being helped in buying time.
Absolutely.
You
yes.
They don't know he traveled incognito. He must have come to Delhi to file the petition.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely.
Arnab, in the UP elections campaign, you know, we have seen a very proactive police raiding this bootlegger, raiding that person. I don't know, when the police find it convenient, they say we have no complaint. Other places, for some reason, they become terribly proactive. I do not think the police can take such inconsistent positions.
Yes, Mr. Subramaniam.
Arnab, the question was raised that the Supreme Court's orders in the Prakash Singh PIL not being implemented is a contempt of court. Remember this, to have a very pliant, very complicit bureaucracy, very pliant, complicit police force is absolutely vital for the political class. Since politics has now become a very huge business, it is essential. Therefore, those in the police force, those in the bureaucracy who are good, who do not want to toe the line, will be quietly sidelined. You won't hear of them ever. They will never become DGPs, they will become chief secretaries. But all the others will be picked up, and those who do not play ball, those who do not tango. So we have to understand, and Shankar Singh said, it's a system issue. These are only minor manifestations that we are seeing. And you see four, there are 400 every day. And that's the reality.
So I'm putting this out today because from the response I'm getting from the news, our viewers and citizens want to feel a confidence in the system. What confidence do they feel when they see Lalu getting away after 20 years? What confidence do they feel when a 66-year-old man is killed like that? Or, as our next story says, and I thank our guests for participating in this robust debate tonight, as our next story says, in the case of Mamata Banerjee, this is what happened when her nephew was produced in court today, this morning at 10 o'clock. Perhaps he was not too concerned. Perhaps he knew his political connections will force the police to go soft on him. And that's exactly what happened in court today. The cops failed to seek custody of the well-connected VVIP nephew Akash Banerjee. He was sent to one-day judicial custody, which effectively means in no time he could be out on bail. The police, which normally in any other case would interrogate a person deeply who dared to assault a public servant, have effectively treated Mamata Banerjee's nephew with velvet kid gloves.